Hello friends, and welcome back to Swift Lessons for another By Request song tutorial. In today's session, I'm going to be breaking down another Beatles classic in their 1965 tune, Norwegian Wood. Now, we're going to get started learning how to play that iconic intro, which we can also apply to all of the verse sections. From there, I'll break down the chord changes and the strumming patterns for the chorus sections as well. Now, I'm using a new microphone configuration here that you might find interesting if you have a home recording studio. I'm coupling two different microphones, the Cascade Fathead and also the Perception 120 by AKG. I'm going to put a link in the description for those microphones. They sound great together, and I think it's really improved the sound of my demonstrations. Now, I've got a full PDF study guide with tabs and chord sheet at patreon.com/swiftlessons. Remember, you can become a member there and gain access to a ton of extra resources for all my popular YouTube guitar lessons. Now, let's get started with a full demonstration of the tune for you to play along with later.
One, two, three, one, two, three. Anywhere. So I looked around and I noticed there wasn't a chair. I sat on her rung, biding my time, drinking her wine. We talked until two, and then she said, "It's time for bed." To laugh. I told her I didn't and crawled off to sleep in the bath. And when I awoke, I was alone. This bird had flown. So I lit a fire.
Okay, close look at the fretboard and also my pick in hand. Getting started with our intro slash verse section. Both parts are played the exact same way. We have a capo here on the second fret. We're in standard tuning, technically the key of E, but since we're playing in D position, we'll be discussing everything as if we're in the key of D major. First, a slow demonstration. One, two, three, one, two, three. Okay, let's break that up. Okay, breaking that up into a few easy to learn sections. The first of which is going to sound like this. Okay, so we have the D major chord fretted. We're going to get started on the first beat, striking the A, the D, maybe the G string together. Then we're going to follow up. Down, up, down, up on the full chord. One. Okay, next we're gonna have a very recognizable melody. Okay, so we already have the second fret of the G string fretted. We're just hammering up to four with the pinky, pulling back off to two, the open G string, the fourth fret of the D string. Then we're gonna go back to the D major chord, put the index finger back down, and play down, up, down to finish up that melody line. So. Okay, now on occasion I'll leave the index finger off and play the G string open. That has a very nice sound to it as well. So. Okay, the choice will be yours. Okay, then after that we're going to play... One more time. Alright, so 2nd fret of the D string, open G, 4th fret D string, open D. Followed by a down up on that D major chord. You put those two sections together and we have. Then we're going to move into the third and final section, which will sound like this. Once again. Okay, so that was the A string, 0, 3, open G string, maybe get a little bit of the B string involved in there too, 2nd fret A. Then we're going to take the D major chord and hammer the middle finger down as you strum. So that strumming pattern is just down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up. But on the first strum, you're doing that hammer on, so it's going to sound like a down, up. All right, you put that entire thing together and it sounds like this. Okay, very good everybody. We have that intro and that verse section down. Now, I want you to consider that throughout the song, there's a lot of different variations to what you've already learned, and also a lot of simplification as you go through the different verses. So, if we're taking what we've already learned and applying it to the first verse, it would sound like this. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
I once had a girl, or should I say, she once had me.
Okay, so as you can see, there's a few different variations there. I tried to stick to that intro as much as possible, but there are some little tiny things that you can do to make it easier to sing and play along to. For example, an easy simplification is to take away the pull-off from that first melody on the guitar. That'll make it go along with the vocal line much easier. So, that would sound like this.
I once had...
Actually striking that 2nd fret of the G string.
A girl... Should I say she once had me?
Now, when we get to the end of it, you might not want to do that hammer on every single time. So instead, you might want to do it on the 2nd measure or exchange it for a hammer on onto the G string or both. That sounds fantastic. Okay, so play with this, make it your own, and don't worry about playing it the same exact way from verse to verse. Okay, excellent work everybody. With the intro and the verse complete, we're ready to move into the chorus. This part is extremely easy, just a basic chord progression and a very simple strumming pattern. It's gonna sound like this. A 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
She asked me to stay and she told me to sit anywhere. So I looked around and I noticed there wasn't a chair.
All right, and that'll get you back into the verse. Okay, so very, very simple. It began with a D minor chord. We're gonna have that for 4 measures in 3/4 time with this very gallopy strumming pattern.
1, 2, and 3, and 1, 2, and 3, and 1, 2, and 3, and 1, 2, and 3, and.
Or down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up. Okay, so very simple strumming pattern. So you do that 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do the same thing over G major. Return to D minor. And then we're going to go to E minor for 2 measures. And then the A major for 2 measures. All right, before jumping back into your verse. So that's the basic Strumman approach. Every now and then they do a down, down, down to kind of amp up the energy in the song. So that could sound like this over the E minor. And also the A major. Okay, great way to boost the energy to get yourself back into the verse or the instrumental section, which is just a repeat of the intro. Okay, now let's apply that D minor to G, to D minor, to E minor, and A major progression to that first chorus. A 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. She asked me to stay and she told me to sit anywhere. So I looked around and I noticed there wasn't a chair. Alright, and then obviously that gets you back into the verse. Congratulations, everybody. If you have that intro and that verse section, you're ready to perform. Alright, friends, thanks so much for checking out this Beatles guitar lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks so much to my supporters at patreon.com/swiftlessons. It's your support that's making all of these lessons possible. Thanks to you guys, I've got many more lessons coming up, so keep checking back. Please subscribe, please share. This is Rob at Swift Guitar Lessons in Philadelphia, saying happy picking.